Hello everyone. My work involves repairing many faulty inverters. They often use AT350 or TLP350 optocouplers to drive the H-bridge, and it's very difficult to test them with a regular multimeter. So in this video, I have built a tool that allows me to easily test optocouplers. It can test both through-hole optocouplers and SMD optocouplers directly on the circuit. This tool is very compact, fitting neatly in the palm of your hand. Inside, it contains a battery, a charger, and an oscillator. On the top, there is a slot for testing through-hole optocouplers, and below that are two LEDs indicating the operating status. I also designed an 8-pin probe to test SMD optocouplers directly on the circuit board. I will test it with a through-hole optocoupler. You can see that with a functional optocoupler, both the green and red LEDs will light up continuously. The green and red LEDs indicate the output states of the optocoupler. If only one LED lights up, it means the optocoupler is faulty and cannot be used. In the SMD optocoupler testing mode, I will use an oscilloscope to connect to the output. As you can see here, with a faulty optocoupler, the output waveform is very poor, and you need to replace it for the inverter to function properly. With a functional optocoupler, the waveform on the oscilloscope will be clean and stable. I'm sharing this entire project with you. You can download the files from the link below the video description and place an order on the JLCPCB website. JLCPCB manufactures PCBs very quickly and at very affordable prices. They also offer many discount codes on their website. By applying a discount code, the cost of the PCB becomes almost negligible. After placing your order, you can track the PCB production process and shipment directly on their website. For 5 PCBs, I only had to pay less than $5, including shipping fees. The price is truly very affordable. After waiting for about a week, I received the PCBs. As always, the quality of the PCBs is excellent. Additionally, I found a case that fits this project perfectly. However, I had to make some adjustments to fit all the components inside. It would be much easier if I had a 3D printer. I plan to save up and buy one next year. This project uses SMD components, which you can solder manually with a soldering iron or use a heat gun. However, I have a suggestion for you. Use JLCPCB's PCBA service. They have a very diverse component inventory that will surely satisfy your needs. PCBA is a service where you simply submit your design and pay, and after a week, you will receive fully assembled PCBs with all components soldered at a very reasonable cost. This is an 8-pin socket. I use it to test through-hole optocouplers, which I frequently use in my designs. Its advantage is that, by pairing it with a socket, you can easily replace any faulty components. This is a TP4-V6 charging module, a very common module for charging 3.7 volts batteries. It costs only $0.2 per unit, making it very affordable. Next to it is a boost converter module. I use it to step up the 3.7 volts to 20 volts. The 20 volts is then split into minus 5 volts and 15 volts using Zener diodes and supplied to the TLP350. As you know, to quickly turn off an IGBT, we need to supply minus 5 volts to its gate. I have finished soldering all the components. Here, I am using a 400 milliamp hour battery. Under normal operating conditions, this circuit only consumes 30 milliamps. Therefore, with this battery, I can use the device for several weeks without needing to recharge. Next, I'll measure the voltage levels and upload the program to the 8E13A chip to complete this project. I will test it with a functional TLP250 optocoupler. The two LEDs will alternate blinking. However, with a burnt-out optocoupler, only the red LED will light up. Similarly, for the SMD optocoupler, we will power on the device and use the probe to connect to the optocoupler on the circuit. An oscilloscope can be used to view the waveform more accurately. Many optocouplers can have leakage, causing them to operate unstably. Using an oscilloscope makes it easier to detect these issues.